Stand by for action.
Thanks for joining me. My name is Dave Milner. I am the Unpleasant Blind Guy, and I want to welcome you to part 3 of this episode of the Unpleasant Blind Guy on EDL Radio. Now remember, if you want to contact me with comments, questions, show suggestions, Awesome American suggestions, I'm available at UBGContact on Twitter, or I can also be found as Dave Milner or Agador, that's A-G-G-E-D-O-R, on Mublet, the Tea Party Community, Spreely, Minds, MeWe, or Gab. Now let's begin. When you listen to the Exceptional Conservative Show, which you can hear and can you can hear this weeknights at 9:05 p.m. Eastern in the United States, and that would be 2:05 a.m. in the UK. When you listen to his show, you will not only get fun, but you will get facts. He is a wonderful writer, and Ken, before we leave, you must give us the information where we can find your writings and everything like that. Folks, we're having a lot of fun, but this is a tremendous commentator that we're speaking to. This is one of the best in the business. And remember, I've been doing this now for 51 years, so I think I know what I'm talking about. Ken, it is tremendous to have you here with us.
Now, well, Dave, first and foremost, that's not what you said in the bar last night to those two young ladies. You told me you were doing it.
Let's keep that quiet. What did you think of $50 was for, man?
I was just wondering if you'd like to let our listeners know, some of the things that you do with the great work that you do with your radio, your writings, and that. Would you like to just, give a little bit of a rundown on some of the things that you do? That's why we think so highly of you for the great work that you've been doing over the time. Would you like to share that with our great listeners out there and some of the things you do?
Jeff, you're awesome, man. I hope someday EDL will be on the TECM TV television network.
We're working on it.
I happen to be the chief executive officer of the Exceptional Conservative Network. You can find me at TECN. Forgive me, theexceptionalconservativeshow.com. Theexceptionalconservativeshow.com. Yeah, I spelled it out that long because I didn't think that the radical jihadists would actually spend too much time typing the whole thing out. So if you go to theexceptionalconservativeshow.com, you'll find all our stuff. Or if you just type in Google Black Conservative TV Owners, I'll pop up. TECN TV, I'll pop up. I started out over about 10 years ago doing a show. I was asked to actually sit in on someone's show for an appearance. And then by popular demand, I was asked to come back on a weekly basis on this show. And then during one of the station breaks, the host said, you need to get your own show because you talk too much. So
that's what being a radio host is all about, kid.
So in 2011, February 28th, I started my own show, dedicating it to God with five basic principles, Christianity being first and foremost, conservatism, capitalism, constitutionalism, and individual sovereignty. And based on those five principles, we went from doing one show a week to popular demand doing three shows, and then I began doing five shows a week, along with a Sunday morning Bible study. And then after 8 years, I decided that in order to get actual treading and strength in the conservative marketplace, a lot of individual renegade black conservatives would have to join one network, and I recommended mine, of course. Of course. So I had a number of black conservatives that started with me, but I began to see that conservatism, Christianity, constitutionalism, individual sovereignty, capitalism is not a race thing at all. It never will be, never was, and never ever will be. So I've opened it to a whole lot of others to be a part of. And what I found is that we became the first black-owned television network to carry CPAC, the Conservative Political Action Committee Conference, the big one in Washington, D.C., that's held annually. We were the first one to actually cover it from pillar to post for the entire
wow.
session with a great number of hosts, black and white, on that network. And we're beginning to grow. We have shows that come out of Italy. We have show out of West Africa. We have the great Pastor Greg Young and so many others. Doctor, and of course, the Mediterranean princess herself, Dr. Jane Ruby. Dr.
Ooh,
Jane.
Yeah.
So she's a gorgeous woman, I'm going to tell you. I'm going to have lunch with her on lunch with her and my producer on Sunday. And
okay,
I'm
jealous
gonna
now.
I know, in my own way, I got to say, Bonnie Wing is my producer. That is a gorgeous woman.
Mm-hmm.
And it, she's brilliant, too. And she lets me know how brainy she is all the time because she won't shut up. But
that'll be the next show on TEC.
It should be. And then the Mediterranean princess, Dr. Jane Rue. Oh, she is fabulously beautiful. And so I'm going to have the most scrumptious lunch this weekend with them as we talk about expanding EDL. Trust me, I will be listening the whole time. I swear I won't stare.
Right. Uh-huh. Yeah, sure. Well, I got to tell you, Ken, Dr. Jane Ruby, she's someone
well, you know,
that I really
Ken,
want to guest on
you know,
our
what
show.
What you say, the way that you've grown, you know, since you started way back 10 years ago, when you first done your first radio show or you joined. Now, look what you've achieved. They say, from mighty acorns, giant oaks. And you're on that road, aren't you? I would say you're coming off a leap of that when you told me a different, of course, that was it Belgium and other countries. It shows how, you know, the message is getting out and how people gravitate to you, Ken, and all what you do. So, you know, you keep doing what you do because you're fantastic, man.
Yeah. Listen, I don't want to take credit for – I don't want to take any needless credit here at all. But at one time, 3% of my listening audience came from Zhejiang, China. So
nice.
when you see them raising that red, white, and blue in China during the protests,
right.
That's because of what a lot of us as conservatives have been doing on the air. A lot of – because this is one of the biggest problems I have with conservatives because they're really identity hawks. How many people are, like, watching me tonight? How many people will watch me? It doesn't matter how many are calculated right there. It's never a complete and accurate measure.
It can't be.
What you can base it on is when they raise the American flag in protest in communist China. That, my friend, tells you you did a great job.
Yeah, that's it.
Well, I
that's
think
it,
for
Ken. That's
when
it right
see,
there.
Yeah,
that's it right there,
I'm talking today
Ken.
About, I've become very close associated with a group that's in Hong Kong, HK. I can't remember the gentleman's name, but I've hooked up with this on Telegram, actually. So I've been following things, and I've just been amazed at the courage and the steadfastness of these people. And what moved me, Ken, was to actually see him singing the national, your national anthem, brother, and raising your flag. Now, man, that moved me. That really did. A lot of us it did.
I think
yeah.
it speaks.
I
think it speaks, as you said, Ken, that's a great way of putting it, because they're really, I've been asked this question about my show since I started the Unpleasant Blind Guy. How many people do you get listening to your show? And really, for us podcasters and people like that, it's really impossible to know because, of course, if you do the show live, it's one thing, and then there are archive listens. People listen to the shows later on their devices, and then they send those shows out to other people. So it's really nigh on to impossible to get a really good read on the numbers. But as you said, I love that,
yeah.
man. When the American flag gets raised and things like that, I mean, in a country that is fighting for its freedom, we know what goes on in Hong Kong. In fact, we sort of predicted in a way what would go on in Hong Kong. You know, but for that to happen is tremendous. And Jeff talks all the time to me about, you know, he'll go in and look at the stats of where our program is being listened to. And it's in all places. Yes, and it is in China. We do have listeners in China. So, you know.
And you got to be.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Dave, but you got to be very careful because I need to speak to a lot of conservatives out there. First and foremost, you're not going to get accurate stats anyway from a liberal company.
Oh, no.
It's not going to happen.
No,
okay?
Never.
CBS would never tell you that you're one of the number one top shows in the world. They would never tell you that. They want you to be dumb and feel like you're ineffectual. But I'm telling you right now, the British Jack being flown, the American anthem being sung, people in communist China, the green protesters in Iran, people in Venezuela, they are listening. People in Russia used to read my stuff. Now I can't see if they read it or not because they put the bars down on that. I'm telling you, people have read it. They know what freedom is. They know what they don't have, and they want freedom. They don't want $1 million. They just want to be free. Freedom with $1 million makes you a trillionaire. Without freedom, a millionaire is nothing in those countries.
That word,
exactly.
Freedom, says it all. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interject there, Ken. What you were saying, I had to say, wow, that's what it's all about, freedom. Everything we stand for. And what we're fighting for now in the UK, we're fighting through for now, as you know, Ken, as Dave knows. You know, and they're trying to take away that, and we will fight it every step of the way. We've got no choice. But, you know, what you said, Ken, I just bowed my head to what you said there because that is so powerful. Your words are so powerful.
See, I'm going I'm going to say something here that you can't say where you are. Okay, so be careful. You can blink me if you can. You know, hit that button if I go too far. This is what I will say. There needs to be a civil war in England, and here's where that war takes place. Where you get rid of your parliament and all those individuals who refuse to protect your freedoms and your liberties and want to sell your nation down the hard, fast road to communism and socialism and want to exchange the right of true religious liberty for the oppression of Islam. That's where you need to begin working, and you need to do it starting right now. Get rid of those individuals that want to oppress you and keep you in chains like Joe Biden.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, I've got to say something, Ken. This is a part of when we do our, you know, the show, it's something that I always put on now, and we've been adding it for a little while, and he's just summed it up. Those who make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable. And, of course, that was said by your great late President John F. Kennedy. And I think what he's just talking, that just summed up. I was looking at that. Just on there, and but I've got to just come back to you with that. What's in our script there, Ken?
Well, I'd like to say something here, Ken. Now, you know, as you know, your talk about civil unrest. You know, it's something that let's just say has been discussed, and inevitably, what happens. With civil unrest, you have the lefties on the one side who are trying to impose their will through violence. And I want to play something that, specifically for you, but of course for Jeff and the listeners as well. I want to play the first part of something, and I want to see if you come to the same conclusion about an individual that I did. Now, guys, what I'm going to play here is from Paul Watson, and I got this off of BitChute. Often I'll go to BitChute instead of YouTube now because they're banning so much. And this is going to be a small part of a thing he did called America's the Mass Shooting Nightmare. Now, Ken, if you don't mind, I'm going to go ahead, and Jeff, I'm going to go ahead and start this, and then I'm going to stop it at the opportune moment. I want to see, Ken, if you come to the same conclusion I did. So let me start this out, guys. This is the English Defense League radio show, by the way, with our special guest, Ken McClinton, CEO of the Exceptional Conservative Network. Let's start this.
America suffered two mass shooting tragedies this past weekend. One was carried out by a right-wing extremist, and the other was carried out by a left-wing extremist. The El Paso gunman said the Republican Party was terrible. He also supported universal income, universal health care, and was an environmentalist, which are all left-wing positions. However, he did hold far-right extremist views on immigration, and that seems to have been the overriding motive behind the attack. So it is accurate to call him a right-wing extremist.
Ah, but now, Ken, the question, did you twig on the same thing that I did about that El Paso shooter?
Okay, Dave, I like that guy sometimes. I don't know his name. I like some of the things that he says.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes he's just jack-off wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
go ahead. There has only in all of the mass shootings in American history, and I'm going to let you know in Britain because sometimes you all get some of that far-left crap off of news media. All of the mass shooters, except for one in the U.S., were members of the called the KKK. The Democrat Party created Jim Crow. The Democrat Party is responsible for Black Lives Matter. The Black Panther, part of the Democrat Party. Everything that is radical, violent, and ruthless in American politics can be traced back to the Democrat Party. What is the Democrat Party subscribed to? Socialism, Marxism, and communism. So if you want violence in your nation, continue to support socialism, communism, and Marxism. Because it will create the political party that will not only indulge violence, but also create the environment they will blame you for your peacefulness.
I've got to call back because situations. So I'll call back in a second. Great to have you here, Ken. And everything you said there, I was nodding my head, but well said, brother. Anyway, I'll be back in a second.
You're listening to EDF.
Well, it's actually the English Defense League radio show that you're listening to. And again, the thing that struck me when I heard that from Paul Watson, and you're right, he usually is pretty good to listen to. I don't agree with him 100%. I don't agree with him on this one. This guy was not a conservative, okay?
No.
As is being touted out there, he is a left-wing race bigot.
Yeah. I concur with you.
See, that was and honestly, Ken, I have to say I'm a little bit ashamed here. Okay, I have to say I'm a little bit ashamed. I can say this to you because you're someone that I will speak to about spiritual issues as well. Okay, it took me until the second time I heard this to actually get it. I heard it the second time and I went, wait a minute, because everything you said in your earlier commentary was absolutely true about this. All you have to do is use DuckDuckGo or a good search engine. Go back and look at the party platform, the 1860 party platform for the Democratic Party. It's got slavery all up in it. The Democrat Party, as Ken has said, was responsible for the beginnings of things like the KKK. They were responsible for much of Jim Crow. Okay, the Democratic Party until they locked onto the possibilities for getting votes, all right, did not give a rat's furry behind about black people, brown people, anything like that. They were the antebellum party. They were the party of race bigots. And to my mind, they still are. Ken, we've spent over in this country $1 trillion in the war on poverty. It hasn't done jack. President Trump gets in and starts working on JOBS, and the economy begins to roar, okay? And yet, the left has been beating us over the head with this, like Rodney King getting beat up with batons and saying that this El Paso guy was a righty. It's obvious he was not. Am I right?
Yeah, I agree with you wholeheartedly, Dave. And one of the things that I must mention regarding the Civil War in the United States of America, the Democrats don't care about whether you are black, Hispanic, whether you are Native American, or if you're white. Democrats don't care about the color of your skin. They really don't. But not in the way that Republicans think. Republicans think it doesn't matter meritoriously because we are all sinners. We've all fallen short of the glory of God. Mm-hmm. We all need to start at the beginning of the line, but it doesn't guarantee how you end. Democrats only have one thing in mind, that a fearless few must be at the top, and then everyone else must serve them. Mm-hmm. Everyone else must be a member of the oppressed. That's what they think, and that's what they do, and that's how they live. They use a whole lot of colorful words. Just like 40 years ago, if you called a black person colored, you would have been knocked out.
Oh, yeah.
Now we are people of color. They mm-hmm. use language to try to tie you up so that you are no longer free. Just like in this conversation, when I talk about black male, this is how well-trained white people are in America now. If I, as a black man, say that a word is offensive, they try to find every other synonym so that they can say the same thing but not use the word. Mm-hmm. I say to you, man, use that damn dictionary. If it's in there, read it. Say it. Sing it. Don't let nobody see in your mind. There you go.
Oh, amen, amen, Ken. I love that. I love that a lot, man. And Jeff, I think you have some things to say to this, because in the UK right now, even though it is supposed to be equal, even though all the people are supposed to be equal, you talk about this, they still try to pull this class nonsense, and inevitably, the people who are, you know, the toffee-nosed, swells, call them, in the UK that try and pull this mess the most are the lefties. Am I right about that, man?
Well, you certainly are. I mean, but you will get the elite. This is what I think, Ken, this is what you mean. There is always those ones at the very top that stirs the pot. And, of course, do they care about us? Of course they don't. Of course they don't. And, of course, you know, in this country now, you know, we used to think that it was a fair country to live in. You know, the laws respected everybody. But it's quite obvious the way that they treated Tommy Robinson. They thrown him in prison. An innocent man. He's a journalist, and a journalist has never been in prison for contempt of court in over 100 years, I think it is, Ken. But in this country now, we've got tyrants that rule over this nation. They won't last too long. As you said, Ken, something is on the way. There is a wind of change. It's going to happen, and it's going to happen very soon, and it'll happen very quick. That's why I'm looking at it. I'm just feeling it. You've got people out there that understands that, and that there is a quickening of a pace, I would say, Ken. I've been talking to Dave about this all the time, but we have notice the quickening in pace at the terms that people are talking now is a big step up, but that's what we expect actually. So you got to beat the war drums to make things happen, haven't you? That's the way I tend to look at it, and unfortunately if you're going to step forward and you're going to step up, you're going to have the situation with Tommy. We got people in prison, language in prison that shouldn't be in prison, been attacked, and they're thrown in prison because they read about it on Facebook. They was disgusted, and before you know it, we had the Facebook police around arresting them and banging them up for 15 months, Ken. Can you believe it?
Someone who got beaten up at an EDL demonstration. Jeff, I got to say this. 40 years ago, Hungary was under the black fist, the iron fist of Russia. Today, it's more free than London.
Yeah.
Get that.
That's right.
Get that. Okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you all, for those people who are listening out of London, you don't impress us by having a jihadist as your mayor. It's not impressive. I know you're going for this diversity thing, but we meant people who have a conservative viewpoint of diversity, not someone who wants to overthrow your nation and throw you out of it. So I'm just saying, if you really, really want your nation to prosper, you need to make sure that you have people in office that believe what you believe, live what you live, and want you to remain free and not make you slaves as they did during the Arabic slave trade. to coin a phrase, it was the beginning of the American slave trade. But nobody wants to talk about that because the American slave trade ended. The British slave trade ended. What didn't end? The Arabic slave trade. If you really want to go back, okay, keep going in the direction that you're going. If you want to move forward, make London great again.
Yeah, well, you know, we've got the human slave trade that is happening as we talk in this country, Ken. We've got the jihadist slave trade working its way across the country. Do you know, Ken, and you might, I think you probably know the statistics, and me and Dave's often talked about it, but you know what, Ken, and this shocks you to the core. There's over 1 million, maybe 1,100,000 girls and boys have been raped, groomed, and passed along, human trafficked. Can you believe that in this little nation of ours, of how bad things have really become? That's why we speak out, and that's why they call us biggest, because we speak out, Ken. We are fighting. We want to be the voice of these children. We want to defend them and for their voices. We want to bring justice, but we stand and we go to these places where these girls are, and we're called all the... You see, the media doesn't want to even write about us. We're not even mentioned.
Yeah.
The only people that mention about us are, you know, citizen journalists out there, or people that's just not under any control of any organisations. That is the situation. But we keep fighting, Ken. You know, we've got no choice. So we love freedom. We want to, and of course, we want to make sure these children are being so badly treated, and you know, that we're going to try to bring some justice. One way or the other, it's got to happen. Because it breaks your heart, doesn't it, Ken? We hear of the plight of what's gone on to these children. You know, even the growing up, having children of their own, even their children have been groomed by these people. It's unbelievable. But,
well,
Ken,
you know,
I'd like to pass it back.
You know what? We used to read fairy tales to our children. Now we allow fairy tales to teach our children in the classroom. The LGBTQRSTUVWXYZ P movement is the most dangerous movement to families in the world. I'm not saying America. I'm not saying London or England. I'm saying the world. To allow someone with a demented mind, and again, homosexuality, lesbianism is a mental illness. Just because they voted you off the island doesn't make you cured. You have a mental illness, and you need to get that checked. The problem with this scenario is that you're allowing mentally ill people to begin making decisions for you and your household about how you want to raise your children and the manner in which they ought to be raised. When God made Adam and Eve, he said male and female. There were not 89 other genders to come along with that. The bottom line is you need to get back to God, get back to the basics of life, get back to the way things are in reality, not in this fantasy fairy tale world where you can be a king and a queen on the same day.
Ken,
I agree with you. And Dave, as I say, I've just noticed we're coming down to time. But Ken, you know, once again, I hope you come back and join us in the near future, brother, because there's so much I want to talk to you, you know, and catch up with you on. But I know you're a busy man. I know you are.
God bless you. I love
the work you do. But having you on the show tonight, you've really made my evening tonight. I know you've made Dave's. And anybody that's listening, this is a great gentleman. Great gentleman there. Ken, let me pass it back to you, buddy.
Yeah, Ken, please tell people where they can find you. And also, don't forget to tell them where they can read your writings, because you really write some great stuff too, man. So please give people the complete rundown on yourself.
Well, all you need to do is go to theexceptionalconservativeshow.com. Or just Google TECN-TV, TECN-TV. And actually, there's a link called Voice of Liberty, a tab. If you click on that, you'll be able to read my stuff. You'll be able to read a whole lot of other people's good stuff, Radar Jackson being one of them, right there on that page. Thank you so much for the opportunity. God bless you all, and God bless America and London.
Anyway. Well, Ken, I got to now I'm going to try and nail down a black man. Here we go. Ken, we were talking about this.
You're racist,
yeah. I know.
Yeah,
I know.
I love it.
Yeah, I'm gonna go have some ice cream later, just because, you know, because it's just a racist thing up too. But sadly, they don't have chocolate. Anyway, you were talking
can
about.
Can I say this real quick?
Wait.
Only in America can you and I both be racist.
Oh, exactly. It is the land of opportunity, Ken. It is the land of opportunity. But I gotta ask you, brother. We were texting about this, kind of joking around the other night. But I'm gonna do to Jeff, what you did to me the other day on the show. 9/11 is coming up, and we will have an observance show for 9/11. Jeff was wondering about having one. On a different day, maybe having it on Wednesday. So here's my proposal for both you and Jeff. Here's my proposal. I'm saying instead of having a show on Thursday, September the 12th, which we would normally have, that would be our normal time, we will have at the same time, maybe get you to call in, Ken, about an hour earlier, say 3:30 or say 3:45 p.m. Eastern. And we will have a show, a 9/11 remembrance show, on the 11th of September, which is a Wednesday. Would you be agreeable to coming on and being a guest on such a show, sir?
I'll definitely be agreeable to doing that. I look forward to doing that with you all, especially since my trip to Israel with Ilhan Omar and Rashida Tlaib was canceled.
Yeah.
I'm available.
I love it, Ken. Ken, thank you for joining us this evening, and
I love you all.
I'm still laughing.
God bless you,
man.
I'm right now.
God bless
you,
Ken, for all the great work
thank you
do, and we will speak again real soon. You take care, and with the forward brother, with all what you do. Cheers,
excellent.
My friend.
Excellent. Yeah, Jeff. What a tremendous guest, eh?
Absolutely awesome tonight.
Oh, yeah, and he's going to be with us, Jeff. You're agreeable, I know. It'll be a bit of a difference. You know, normally people hear us on Thursday, but hey, why not have, as you said, a special 9/11 show on the 11th? That'll be a Wednesday. And, yeah, we will have Kenneth McClinton with us. I know he'll be able to provide some great insights. You guys just got a little bitty example of what this man can do. It's the tip of the iceberg of his brilliance, and he is brilliant. So please check out his show, The Exceptional Conservative Show, 9:05 p.m. Eastern. He's taking a vacation this week. It's 9:05 p.m. Eastern time in the United States, and that is 2:05 a.m. in the U.K. Please check it out. Okay, let's put it this way, guys. Shows that it would take me a week to prepare for, he prepares for it in a day. That's how brilliant he
Amazing.
Is, Jeff. And I, you know,
I just want to say
what a show. What a show. I want to thank him for being there. And I just want to say to everybody, please check out the Unpleasant Blind Guy page at Spreaker.com. My shows are 1 p.m. Eastern. That's 6 p.m. in the U.K., Monday through Friday. And I do a show on Saturday at midnight Eastern. And that is 5 a.m. in the U.K., please check it out there. It can also be heard on SHR Media, on the SHR Media YouTube page, and the Western Free Radio Network. Jeff, it's been a fantastic, tremendous show. Jed, we're thinking about you. We love you all. And I just want to say to the foot soldiers, angels, and Brexiteers, and all of the world patriots out there, be prosperous, be blessed, and no surrender. Back to you, Jeff. We're just about done.
Yeah, no surrender ever. And Thorpe Bye and Flycat, thank you for joining us this evening. As I say, we'll be back. What day is it today? It's Thursday, isn't it, day? We'll be back this Sunday, and I've got 2 minutes, 22 seconds. Let's do this. Thank you so much, Ken, for being an awesome, awesome guest this evening. And so we'll be back again this Sunday. And Dave, what you set up there was awesome. Thank you for the slides, Dave, and the scripting tonight, as usual. Fantastic work, and a big mwah to our Jan out there. God bless you too. With that, we've got no choice. We've got to go underground, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go.
Well,
Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. 2 hours. 2 hours went by. It was such, it's like a blur. Once again, we've said this quite a lot, that it's like a blur when we do these radio shows. But Ken McClinton, what can we say about this gentleman? He was an awesome, awesome guest this evening. And, yeah, he's going to, it's seems that, thank you, Dave, for having a chat to Ken. And Ken will be joining us. We're going to do a 9/11 special. We're doing it on the day, so we'll be doing something a bit special, and Ken will be joining us for that day. So it's this could be really a good day. But anyway, for myself and Dave and the team, I'm thinking about Jan out there. God bless you, Jan. Everybody associated with the EDL Radio Show, our great media team out there, with the organisation. Good on you guys. So we'll be back again this Sunday. Plenty of information's coming out there with a lot of stories that's just unfolding. We'll be talking about a lot of these stories come Sunday. So from myself, from Dave, from the team, we'll see you this Sunday. So you take care, stay safe. And just remember, guys, just remember, be vigilant out there, okay? We think of you. You know, so with that, good night, and we'll see you Sunday. It's the English Defence League radio show signing off for tonight. No surrender, ever. Good night, everybody.
And that is it for this time. I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for listening, and may your God go with you. Goodbye. The Unpleasant Blind Guy is copyright 2019. Anno Domini. Now for Dave's Canes, extras that help you navigate the new media world.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.
Hey, this is Michael Wright.
And I'm Shannon Wright.
Join us for The Right Way with Shannon and Mike, Monday through Thursday from 7 to 9 a.m. right here on SHR Media.
Why are they joining us?
For fun things like sports, politics.
Oh, maybe some news and entertainment?
And all kinds of other things.
Money and recipes and events, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, so join us Monday through Thursday, 7 to 9 a.m. here on shrmedia.com.
From a public locker inside a dilapidated Long Island rail station comes a show designed to piss off liberals using truth, facts, and ridicule. The Lid Radio Show, featuring the conservative voice from the People's Republic of New York, the Lid himself, Jeff Dunitz. Tune in every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com. At Lid Radio, we fight for the truth, justice, and a good kosher T-bone. If you don't listen, Hillary Clinton might sneak into your bedroom in her house coat late at night and blame you for her election loss. It's the Lid Radio Show with Jeff Dunitz.
It's your business diva here, Melanie Collette. I am inviting you to a front row seat as I discuss some of the most intriguing details of wealth and finance with today's movers and shakers in the world of business. Listen in and discover financial truths on a global, domestic, and household scale. Uncover topics that will impact your wallet today and in the future. Money Talk with Melanie airs Monday through Friday, 5 p.m. East, 2 p.m. West, right here on SHR Media and High Plains Pundit Talk Radio. You can't afford to miss it.
The new show on the SHR Media Network, Sackheads Against Tyranny, on shrmedia.com. Go there quick like a bunny, 11 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Pacific, every Wednesday, live and direct on the SHR Media Network, shrmedia.com. Be there.
broadcasting behind enemy lines in occupied California, a mere 2 miles from the state capital. The bloviating Zeppelin's Berserk Bobcat Saloon Radio Show can be heard every Tuesday and Thursday night at 8 p.m. Pacific and 11 p.m. Eastern, only on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com to listen. You can also watch on the SHR Media Facebook page and the SHR Media YouTube channel. No goldfish were abused in the making of this ad.
Hey girls, Carry Girl Gear is here. More and more women every day are concealed carrying, participating in competitive shooting, and getting firearms training. It's not a boys club anymore, and we don't have to shop in their stores anymore either. Finally, a cool and unique clothing line just for women. Dope tees and hats for the patriotic concealed carry and 2A girl. So what are you waiting for? Go check out carrygirlgear.com today.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.